Good evening and welcome to MTV's news update for today, January 4, 2022. I'm Sani Ramotar for Sawa Top Headlines. Almost 500 new COVID cases recorded in 24 hours. Health Minister confirms COVID cases at the GPHC. Minister Sakai boasts of successful year in 2021. And in sport, one Ghana cycling group rides set for late January. Now for the news in details. As COVID cases continue to surge, almost 500 new infections were recorded in the last 24 hours across the country. More in this report.
Health Minister Dr. Frank Anthony said there has been a significant increase in the number of people infected with the novel coronavirus. Almost 500 new cases were recorded in the last 24 hours.
So in the last 24 hours, we had 485 new cases. So our active cases are now 1,824. So that's a big jump. It's probably the highest total we have had in a day. And maybe these numbers would even go further.
Of the active cases, 1,138 were recorded in Region 4, 272 in Region 6, and 148 in Region 3, while 41 active cases were recorded in Region 2, 78 in Region 9, and 74 in Region 10.
With the Omicron variant, it is highly contagious, and it doubles, the numbers doubles every 4 days or so. You can see those numbers going up. So if people are not taking precautions, if people not wearing their masks, keeping their distance, being in ventilated room, wearing N95 masks, more and more people are going to get sick.
Minister Anthony noted too that 66 persons are infected in New Amsterdam, 45 in Lethem, 21 in Bartiga, and 26 in Wismar. On the east bank of Demerara at Diamond, 43 people are infected, 33 at Providence, 20 in Grove, and 17 at Hurstellin. On the east coast, 17 infections were recorded in Nonpareil, 49 in Kitty, 36 in Sophia, 35 in Lodge, and 27 at La Penitence.
So right now we have 64 persons in hospital. Over the last 24 hours, we had, I think, about 10 persons that came into the different hospitals. We currently have 36 persons at the Ocean View Hospital, with 8 of those persons in the ICU, and a few of those persons are intubated. All of the 8 are receiving oxygen, but I think 2 of them are intubated.
So far, 296,424, or 57.8% of adults, are fully vaccinated.
Health Minister Dr. Frank Anthony said several persons, including doctors and nurses, have tested positive for the coronavirus at the Georgetown Public Hospital. Here is more.
Health Minister Dr. Frank Anthony, during today's COVID-19 update, has confirmed that several persons have tested positive for the coronavirus at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation. He said mitigation measures have been put in place to prevent the further spread of the deadly virus.
So it has not had a big impact so far on service delivery, but if more and more people get sick, well, then obviously it's going to have an impact. But so far, with the persons who got sick, we're monitoring them. Most of them are either asymptomatic or mildly symptomatic, and we expect that they will return to work shortly.
Only recently, the health minister met with the senior management staff of the hospital to discuss additional measures to be taken to protect both patients and staff from the Omicron variant. These additional measures are expected to be put in place soon. Minister Anthony had urged persons to adhere to the basic COVID-19 measures, as the World Health Organization had announced that the variant was already present in more than 6 or 7 countries. While no case of Omicron has thus far been confirmed in Guyana, the health minister believes that the variant may be present here.
You're watching MTV's News Update. More news on the other side of the break. Stay with us.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any 5 numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. Our wall and ceiling gypsum system. It's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Cherry Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
Will you be there when we come to play? Will you be there to see our stars shine? Will you be there? 24/6 and not miss it, no.
The ICC Under-19 Men's Cricket World Cup is coming to the West Indies. Be there January 14th to February 5th. Get your free ticket at www.u19cwc.com/tickets.
Will you be there?
This is MTV's news update. Welcome back. Minister of Armenian Affairs, Pauline Sokhai, has declared 2021 a successful year as 90% of the ministry's plans have been completed. Here is Rihanna Griffith.
Minister of Armenian Affairs, Pauline Sokhai, said the development of Armenians remain a commitment of the People's Progressive Party Civic, PPPC administration. Minister Sokhai said she is pleased with her ministry's achievement this year, despite a few shortcomings. She was at a time being interviewed on a national communications network.
In terms of our commitments made in the campaign, we have covered almost, I would say, 90% of what we said we were to do.
Minister Sokhai said some 2,000 community service officers, CSO, were trained to serve their community. Most of these youths benefited from employment opportunities in their communities.
They will be able to not only manage, but they'll be able to train their peers, the women, farmers, youths, school children. They will also be able to provide support to teachers and nurses who may very well have to use the computer and connectivity, internet connectivity.
Another program targeting the development of women is the garment construction program. This allows women in remote areas to sew and sell uniforms. The materials and equipment required for the sewing of the uniforms were provided by the Ministry of Armenian Affairs. Minister Sokhai noted too the ministry has expended a total of $1.73 billion to support economic activity and projects in hinterland communities. These communities were also beneficiaries of the Because We Care cash grant and COVID relief grants. Minister Sokhai assured a number of plans are in place this year that will benefit Armenian communities.
First, we will be concentrating on helping and securing the Ministry of Agriculture support for better agricultural technical services and techniques in agriculture. We will be looking also at the youths, women, tourism. So it's not going to be majorly different. It's a work in progress. It means we're going to advance to what we've started and we will expand.
Reporter for MTV's News Update, Rihanna Griffith.
The reopening of the Rose Hall Estate in East Burmese quarantine is scheduled to open in the second quarter of this year, where over 1,500 extra workers will be rehired. More in this report.
The Rose Hall Estate was one of the four estates closed in 2017 under the former APNU-AFC government. This placed more than 10,000 workers on the bird line. However, in keeping with the PPPC's manifesto promise, the estate is on course for a reopening in the second quarter. This is according to President of the Guyana Agricultural and General Workers Union, GAWU, Sipol Norain.
There is a lot of work ongoing, and by all measures, Rose Hall is going to be reopened this year. There is a lot of work being done to have Rose Hall reopened by the second crop of this year. So, as the estate operates and the, you know, the field work and so on become more extensive, I'm seeing that employment levels could move up to about 1,500 minimum.
Already some 700 ex-sugar workers were rehired. CEPOL has commended the administration on its effort to rehire these sugar workers.
Not only are people being re-employed, but the fact that you have support being given to them as well. You know, it is allowing them to breathe life back into their family, into their community.
The APNUAFC government in 2017 shut four estates, namely Wales, Rose Hall and Moore and Albion, leaving some 10,000 workers on the breadline. The PPPC government has committed to have these workers re-employed. The Albion estate has already reopened and other economic activities are being pursued at the Enmore and Wales Sugar Estate, which will see these ex-sugar workers being re-employed. Reporter for MTV's News Update, Rihanna Griffith.
The Central Housing and Planning Authority regularized over 750 informal settlers residing in regions 4 and 5 last year, while 59 persons squatting on government reserves were relocated. This was revealed by Minister of Housing and Water Colin Crowe during a recent interview with the Department of Public Information. He emphasized that the PPPC government has embarked on a national housing plan that caters for the housing needs for all Guyanese, and therefore there is absolutely no need for persons to engage in illegal land occupation. Last year, the Housing Ministry launched the Ghana Strategy for Informal Settlements Upgrading and Prevention, a program which seeks to address and ultimately eliminate squatting across the country. Minister Kroll explained that the program will result in squatting being dealt with in a more structured way, taking into consideration the increased number of squatter settlements across the country, given the influx of migrants into the country. Still ahead, GCOPD proposes 100% in public assistance for persons living with disabilities, and GNBS records successful year in verification and product monitoring services.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step 1, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step 2, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step 3, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step 4, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Now using Softex toilet tissue. Available in leading supermarkets countrywide, Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Fibertech materials are used in a multitude of ways, from repairing and fabrication of auto body, fishing and household items. We have available various fiberglass mattings, resin, mold releases, brushes and rollers for all of your repair needs. We offer technical advice and free training to ensure you get the job done. For further information, call us at 220-6907 or 220-9192.
You're tuned to MTV's News Update. The Ghana Council of Persons with Disability has proposed to the Human Services and Social Ministry a 100% increase in public assistance to persons living with disabilities. Here is more.
Program coordinator of the Ghana Council of Persons with Disabilities, Ganesh Singh, said persons with disabilities can expect to benefit from a number of initiatives this year. He noted one of the major proposals put forward to the Ministry of Human Services and Social Security is to increase the public assistance.
All right, we would have asked the government to increase public assistance at least by 100% from 2017 to 2018. from $12,000 to $24,000. We would have asked for more allocations be given to special education needs, delivery of special education needs through the Ministry of Ministry of Education. We would have also asked for subventions or grants be given to the various disabled people organizations to help better to help them administer programs and operate an office, whether it's on a part-time basis.
Singh commended the government for the many initiatives that were offered to persons living with disabilities this year.
We would have partnered with various government ministries and agencies to, in the work that they do to promote the rights of persons with disabilities. We had a successful Disability Week, where we had a cocktail reception hosted by Her Excellency, the First Lady of Guyana, and His Excellency. That's something that really raised the profile.
Only recently, the Central Housing and Planning Authority and the Guyana National Bureau of Standards partnered to provide training in block making for persons with disabilities. This will help these persons to gain employment. In addition to this, the government recently distributed a one-off cash grant valued at $25,000 for persons living with disabilities. Reporter for MTV's News Update, Rihanna Griffith.
The Ghana National Bureau of Standards has recorded a successful year for 2021 as the organization continued to ensure accurate measurements in trade and eliminate substandard products from the local markets. During 2021, a total of 44,501 measuring devices were verified, which included 8,515 scales compared to 5,653 in 2020, 15,292 masses compared to 11,450 in 2020, and 19,129 electricity meters as compared to a total of 27,554 devices in 2020. In addition, with 189 weight per scales used in the rice, sugar, transportation and retail sectors verified in 2021, there was a significant increase when compared to the 146 weight per scales verified in 2020. Further, 105 moisture meters used by millers to determine the moisture content of paddy supplied by farmers were verified in 2021 as compared with 59 in 2020. Notably, the GNBS commenced the verification of breathalyzers in 2021, resulting in 10 instruments being verified for the Ghana Police Force and other private entities. In October, the Bureau also launched its speed guns verification service. We now take a look at tips for healthy living, brought to you with the kind compliments of Natura's High and Low Milk Powder distributed by Dami's Variety.
What does Natura High and Low Milk Powder have? It is fortified with the extra goodness of vitamins A, C, D, E, and K. It is high in calcium, protein, and enriched with folic acid, all of which help to strengthen your immune system. What it doesn't have is fat and cholesterol. Natura, high and low, healthy, can taste good. Available at all leading supermarkets and groceries nationwide. Natura High and Low Milk Powder is not for infants 1 year and under.
Gingivitis is a common and mild form of gum disease that causes irritation, redness, and swelling of your gingiva, the part of your gum around the base of your teeth. It is important to take gingivitis seriously and treat it promptly. Gingivitis can lead to much more serious gum disease called periodontitis and tooth loss. The most common cause of gingivitis is poor oral hygiene. Good oral health habits such as brushing at least twice a day, flossing daily, and getting regular dental checkups can help prevent and reverse gingivitis. Symptoms. Healthy gums are firm and pale pink and fitted tightly around the teeth. Signs and symptoms of gingivitis include swollen or puffy gums, dusky red or dark red gums, gums that bleed easily when you brush or floss, bad breath, receding gums, tender gums. Causes. The most common cause of gingivitis is poor oral hygiene that encourages plaque to form on teeth, causing inflammation of the surrounding gum tissues. Here's how plaque can lead to gingivitis. 1. Plaque forms on your teeth. Plaque is an invisible, sticky film composed mainly of bacteria that forms on your teeth when starches and sugars in food interact with bacteria normally found in your mouth. Plaque requires daily removal because it reforms quickly. 2. Plaque turns into tartar. Plaque that stays on your teeth can harden under your gum line into tartar, which collects bacteria. Tartar makes plaque more difficult to remove. creates a protective shield for bacteria and causes irritation along the gum line. Tartar makes plaque more difficult to remove, creates a protective shield for bacteria, and causes irritation along the gum line. You need professional dental cleaning to remove tartar. 3. Gingiva become inflamed, resulting in gingivitis. The longer that plaque and tartar remain on your teeth, the more they irritate the gum, causing inflammation. In time, your gums become swollen and bleed easily. This may also result in tooth decay. If not treated, gingivitis can advance to periodontitis and eventual tooth loss. Risk factors. Gingivitis is common and anyone can develop it. Factors that increase your risk of gingivitis include poor oral care habits, smoking or chewing tobacco, older age, dry mouth, poor nutrition including vitamin C deficiency, dental restorations that do not fit properly or crooked teeth that are difficult to clean. Prevention. 1. Good oral hygiene. That means brushing your teeth for 2 minutes at least twice daily, in the morning and before going to bed, and flossing at least once a day. Even better, brushing after every meal or snack or as your dentist recommends. Flossing before you brush allows you to clean away the loosened food particles and bacteria. 2. Regular dental visits. See your dentist or dental hygienist regularly for cleanings, usually every 6 to 12 months. 3. Good health practices. Practices such as healthy eating and managing blood sugar if you have diabetes are also important to maintain gum health. Treatment. Prompt treatment usually reverses symptoms of gingivitis and prevents its progression to more serious gum disease and tooth loss. You have the best chance for successful treatment when you also adopt a daily routine of good oral care and stop tobacco use. Professional gingivitis care includes 1. Professional dental cleaning. Your initial professional cleaning will include removing all traces of plaque, tartar, and bacterial products. 2. Dental restoration if needed. Misaligned teeth or poorly fitting crowns, bridges, or other dental restorations may irritate your gums and make it harder to remove plaque during daily oral care. If problems with your teeth or dental restorations contribute to your gingivitis, your dentist may recommend fixing these problems. 3. Ongoing care. Gingivitis usually clears up after a thorough professional cleaning, as long as you continue good oral hygiene at home. If you are consistent with your home oral hygiene, you should see the return of pink healthy gum tissue within days or weeks. Lifestyle and home remedies. Steps you can take at home to prevent and reverse gingivitis include 1. Brush your teeth twice a day or after every meal or snack. 2. Use a soft toothbrush and replace it at least every 3 to 4 months. 3. Consider using an electric toothbrush, which may be more effective at removing plaque and tartar. 4. Floss daily. 5. Use a mouth rinse to help reduce plaque between your teeth. 6. Get regular professional dental cleanings on a schedule recommended by your dentist. 7. Do not smoke or chew tobacco.
What does Natura High and Low Milk Powder have? It is fortified with the extra goodness of vitamins A, C, D, E, and K. It is high in calcium, protein, and enriched with folic acid, all of which help to strengthen your immune system. What it doesn't have is fat and cholesterol. Natura, high and low. Healthy can taste good. Available at all leading supermarkets and groceries nationwide. Natura High and Low Milk Powder is not for infants 1 year and under.
The ISG and MTV's Sport Update comes up after the break with Jessica Callender. Stay tuned.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Are you building or renovating your home? Then come to Beeson for a wide range of aluminum and UPVC windows and doors. Get from single hung sash, awning, casement, sliding windows, plus sliding and swinging doors. All our products can be customized and fitted with insect screens and are sealed tight to withstand harsh weather conditions. At Beeson, we also carry commercial, glass and French doors, showcases, aluminum louvers, curtain walls, aluminum rails, plus sliding and frameless shower doors. So look no further. Visit our showroom today at Lot 1228 Eccles Industrial Site or call 622-4197
or 623-4197. Beeson Windows and Doors. Build with pride in Guyana. By Guyanese.
Win big with Ultra Lubricants. Win a Toto backpack every week. To enter, purchase any Ultra Lubricants. Send us a picture of your receipt via WhatsApp to 604-5810. Winners will be randomly chosen weekly. Promotion ends February 28, 2022. ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
The Next Gen Golf Academy will be providing golf scholarships to 1,000 students on an annual basis in an effort to make the sport more accessible.
Aleem Hussein, president of the Guyana Golf Association's Next Gen Golf Academy, said the academy provided 200 National Grade 6 Assessment B-School graduate scholarships last year. However, the academy is looking to increase this number in this new year.
Part of the golf scholarship program that we came up with was in response to, as you are aware, there are a lot of families who do not have the benefits of private tutoring or access their single-parent homes. And those kids may just freeze up at an exam. They just don't perform as well at an exam. And we saw a lot of the schools and the districts and the companies awarding the top performers of in all schools. And that's fantastic. But we also felt that all performers should have a chance.
This is part of the association's ongoing initiative to make golf available and accessible to players from all walks of life and make golf the most played sport countrywide.
Get a golf scholarship, which allows them full access to golf all year long, free equipment, free coaching, and all they have to do is show up so they can learn this fantastic game and possibly become part of the new national team that would represent Guyana in the future Olympics.
A central component of the Next Gen Golf Academy's plan is the continued rollout of the school program, which will see thousands of children given golf training as part of the physical education curriculum, with over 80 secondary schools being among the early adopters.
The second annual One Guyana Cycling Group Ride is set to take place from January 27 to the 31st.
The first ever One Guyana Cycling Group Ride was successfully held in 2019, but hadn't been able to continue due to the pandemic. However, the annual event will return on Thursday, January 27th, and will last for 3 days. It will be the three-stage ride starting at the National Park Tarmac. This is according to event organizer Kwame Ridley.
We will overnight in Skeldon. We take some refreshment, take a rest. And then the very next day, we will cross the border, which is in Suriname, Nikiri, and continue the ride. That's the second leg. We will then proceed to Koroni, Nikiri, where we'll take a rest and go again the following day from Koroni to Paramaribo.
The One Guyana Group Ride is a cross-country ride open to all cyclists at every level who would like to participate. The event organizers are aiming to have at least 50 persons participate in the ride.
We have three contact number on the flyer that we post online. So anyone who want to be a part of it, just make call any one of those number. And it's very simple. When you call that number, what we're trying to do, we would add you to a WhatsApp group. So automatically, you will get to join a group with people that is going on the ride.
However, all participants must be vaccinated with at least 2 doses. The organizers are still seeking sponsorship for the hosting of the event.
Person could use this ride as a challenge. Person could use this ride as a bucket list, something that they want to prove themselves that they can do this 3-day ride.
It's a ride for challenging people who want to do rides like these. They got a group rides, people who normally don't race, but they ride cross-country races, ride from one country to another. And it's also a promotion really from the cyclists in Guyana who never went to Suriname could get to see Suriname.
World number one tennis player Novak Djokovic will defend his Australian Open title late this month after receiving a medical exemption from having a COVID-19 vaccination.
Novak Djokovic's participation in the Australian Open had been in doubt for some months after it was announced that all players participating must be fully vaccinated. Djokovic, a 9-time Australian Open winner, has refused to disclose his vaccination status. This is according to BBC Sport. However, the tournament organizers recently revealed that they would allow unvaccinated players under the condition that their application for a medical exemption be assessed anonymously by two separate panels. Djokovic has not revealed the circumstances of his exemption, but conditions that would qualify players for an exemption are recently testing positive for COVID, inflammatory cardiac illness, or another acute condition listed as a valid reason. Djokovic has won the past three Australian Opens and is in a three-way tie on 20 majors with Roger Federer, who misses the tournament through injury, and Rafael Nadal in the all-time list. The tournament begins in Melbourne on 17th January.
The Georgetown Cricket Association and the Ghana Cricket Board have extended sincere condolences to the family of the late past president of the GCA, Sherlock Atwell, who passed away last Sunday. Atwell was a credit to the local cricket fraternity in his capacity as a player representing the Essequibo County and a Demerara Cricket Club. He served with distinction as president of the GCA for 5 consecutive terms and president of the Demerara Cricket Club. He had also been on grounds curator for the Ghana Cricket Board during test and first class matches, liaison officer for teams visiting Ghana, and as an office manager to the West Indies team. The Ghana Cricket Board's Best of the Best Red Ball 40 tournament is set to begin tomorrow.
The first match of the Ghana Cricket Board GCB's regional 4-day tournament is slated to begin tomorrow at the Albion Community Centre ground from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. A 30-man squad has been named for the match that will be among events used to select the national team for the CWI Regional 4-day Tournament 2022. This tournament involves a pool of earmarked players participating in competitive matches for a chance of selection. The squad includes players such as Shimran Hetmeyer, Tej Narayan Chandapal, Veerasamy Pramal, Kevin Sinclair, and Rampratap Ramnath. The matches are also in keeping with the body's promise to play national matches within the three counties as against the centralized location of Demerara. The scheduled dates for the other two matches are January 12 to 15, 2022 and January 18 to 21, 2022. President of the GCB, Bisundial Singh, noted that the board hopes to return to inter-county, national trials and practice matches in all counties.
That brings us to the end of Sport Update, which was brought to you by the kind compliments of ISG. Or after the break.
Win big with Ultra Lubricants. Win a Toto backpack every week. To enter, purchase any Ultra Lubricants. Send us a picture of your receipt via WhatsApp to 604-5810. Winners will be randomly chosen weekly. Promotion ends February 28, 2022. ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
And that brings down the curtain on tonight's newscast. But before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Almost 500 new COVID cases recorded in 24 hours. Health Minister confirms COVID cases at the GPHC. Minister Sukai boasts of successful year in 2021. And his sport, One Guyana Cycling Group, rides set for late January. Catch our rebroadcast tomorrow at 6:30. Don't forget to like our Facebook page where the news can be viewed live at 19:30. On behalf of our news and technical teams, Sandy Ramodar Singh, stay safe and goodbye for now.